everyone, and welcome to a very special episode of Ghazali. She calls herself half Goan, half Peruvian, but her fame is completely international. From back-to-back cover pages with leading international magazines like Vogue, Cosmopolitan, Elle, Glamour, GQ, Harper's Bazaar, and who can forget her Maxim cover with heartthrob Ranveer Singh, to representing prestigious brands like Westside and Adidas. She has cemented her position as the next big name to watch out for in Bollywood. A hot favorite of the paparazzi, and why not? She made her Bollywood debut in 2016 with a cameo in Kapoor & Sons. She went on to work in Badla with the one and only Amitabh Bachchan himself, and her latest work was with the super hit franchise Houseful 4 with Akshay Kumar. Thanks to her mixed heritage, she is currently in talks to appear in multiple big budget films in India and abroad. If you haven't guessed who I'm talking about yet, it's none other than supermodel, influencer, actress, philanthropist, and jet-setting British superstar, Elena Fernandez.
Hi, thank you very much.
Hi, Elena. Thank you for being here with us today.
Thank you so much, Heather. It's a pleasure to be here.
So you're half Goan, half Peruvian.
Yes.
But you were born and brought up in London.
Yes, so my father is Indian, he's Goan, and my mother is from Peru in South America. But I was born and raised in London. But I have an OCI, so I'm basically an Indian citizen, but with a British passport.
Did you grow up with any Goan influences?
No, actually, I haven't had any Goan influences, but I'm very well connected with the Goan community. I've spent a lot of time here. I'm here now for IFFI, so I've always tried my best to make Goa proud, whether it was with the Kingfisher calendar, which I did twice, which was a first for any Goan.
Do you have family here? Do you visit Goa often?
So I no longer have any family here, but I try to visit Goa as much as I can. I wish I could actually visit more, but that's definitely on my bucket list for next year, to spend more time relaxing, taking it in Goa. Yeah.
Look forward to seeing you.
I know.
Perhaps sunbathing on one of our lovely beaches.
I know, either sunbathing on one of the beaches or eating some of the delicious food.
Cuisine.
Yeah, exactly.
Have you tried the fish curry?
Yeah, no, I've tried the fish curry. Okay. So it's very nice. Very spicy, but very nice.
So you've come a long way since you started. You reached the top of your game and then you decided to transition to film. What's it been like in Bollywood?
So for me, obviously, starting off with Kapoor & Sons was just, it's a next level dream, you know? But for me, it was a natural transition from, first of all, being a model to then doing TV commercials and print campaigns and then to film. So for me, it wasn't a huge jump. It was just something that, you know, it just flowed. It was a very kind of natural transition.
Even in Badla, I mean, you worked with power-packed performers like
I've been very lucky. Everything's been power-packed. I think it's the Goan luck, you know?
Let's hope so.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, you know, it's every aspiring actor, or even if you're established, it's a dream to work with Amitabh Bachchan. Yeah. What was it like working?
For me, first of all, I was surprised at how tall Amitabh was, because I'm very tall.
You're tall.
I'm very tall.
Yes, you're tall.
And Amitabh was even taller than me. So for me, and he's just so powerful, like his whole presence and attitude. And honestly, he's super wonderful, very humble, very down to earth. We were there at the screening and he's just so great. I can understand why he's such a staple of Bollywood. You know, why he has all the fans outside his house every day. He's just such a character.
So working with Amitabh Bachchan, and then you worked with the next big thing, which was Ranveer Singh.
Oh yeah, I'm Ranveer.
So, I mean, they're complete opposites.
Yeah, they are.
So what was Ranveer like?
Ranveer is a huge personality. You know, he's a lot of laughs, he makes everything so much fun, but he's also got such a like pure, genuine soul to him as well. So they're both super amazing, very lovely, and just obviously both extremely talented. I'm a massive fan of both of their works.
Are you working with any of them or, you know, any other big names?
Yes, another big name next year.
Are you going to tell us?
I can't. That's the thing. When you sign into these films, you're then under contract, so you need to... They will tell you when you can start speaking about the film. Right now I can't.
Have you started shooting yet?
Yeah, we've already finished it.
Okay.
It's all done and everything. It's scheduled to release next year.
Are you talking about Lakshmi Bomb or Janiman or any of these?
I can't say anything.
Okay. Yeah. Not even a little hint?
No. There'll still be like two major films next year, which I'm looking forward to.
Okay. Well, all the best.
Thank you.
They're super hit franchises.
I know. So do I. I mean, they're both very beautiful films the script is very lovely. So let's see.
Can you tell us what genres they're in or?
Let me think, one genre. Okay, one is a biopic. And the other is a very, I would say, like a very light-hearted family comedy.
So two different...
Two completely different films, yeah. Okay. So for me, it's nice to do films which are completely different because it opens you up to a complete varied audience. So sometimes the people who, for example, went to see Houseful 4, which is a funny comedic franchise, is different to the audience, for example, for Butler. You know, because that's like a thriller-type suspense film. So opening myself up more to different parts of the public.
Well, awesome. I wish you all the best. I hope, you know, we get a chance to watch both films here in Goa. And
I know 100%, and I will have to come back when they do the screenings
you,
here.
You must come for one 100%, of the premieres.
100%, I will be here.
You're very popular on social media. You've got millions of followers on Instagram. Mm. But there's also a flip side to social media where you have bullying and trolls. So how do you react to such negativity? Or how would you, you know, tell someone like me to react?
I mean, the thing is that when you react to negativity, you're just throwing more like fuel on the fire, you know, because people want a reaction from you. If you just ignore them, they are actually just going to go away because you're not entertaining them. As soon as you start entertaining hatred, you kind of open yourself up to be in their negative, you know, dark world. So sometimes if I see some kind of vile comments or some which are inciting some sort of hatred or discrimination, I won't be aggressive back, but I will educate and correct them. And I will just literally make like maybe like a few sentences of saying, you know, I feel sorry for them. If you feel the need to troll somewhere on a computer, like somewhere like 10,000 miles away, 15,000 miles,
who you
yeah,
are.
No one knows. Like if you feel that need, then I actually feel sorry for you, that you actually have the time to spew such hatred like on social media. Then I actually feel sorry for you. I don't feel anger towards you. I feel pity for you.
So I think the advice would be stay calm, breathe.
Yeah, because the thing is that people want a reaction. When someone is mean to you, it's because they want you to react. If you don't react, then it's not going to affect you. Don't let something so bad affect your own mental peace. You know, that's the main thing. And because all it's going to do is it's going to affect you. It's going to affect your own vibrations. It's going to affect your soul. And it's tempting to react, you know? You really want to. And trust me, at times I really want to react. But no, I don't. I just ignore it. And there's actually more power in ignoring than responding.
Yes, it definitely
because
does.
Because you're giving that person importance, you know?
And you're giving them power over you.
Exactly, so why do that? They're not worth it. If anything, I'm just like, you know, I wish you all the best. Do as you please.
So your Instagram page says, one person can change the world.
Yeah.
I believe you also have a charity titled I Am Change.
I Am Change, yes. And that's because one person can change the world, you know?
Can you tell us about some change you would perhaps like to see in the world?
So for me, I want to change the mentality of people that they feel that they can't make a difference. They see there's so many issues or they think that, you know, the issue is too great to change. But the thing is, say for example, there's a population of 1.3 billion people in India. If everyone changed can't to can, then you will make a difference. You just have to start. And you're not talking about a big difference. You're talking about just small changes, whether it's smiling at the street kid that repeatedly knocks on your window, you know, feeding the stray animal, some of
your
leftover food.
You're also a big you're an advocate for PETA and...
Yeah, especially for animal welfare, because animals and, you know, kids are defenseless. So when you're in a position where you can use your voice and platform to make a difference, I think it's very important. You know, small acts of kindness is all that's needed, is to change that individual or that animal's world. You know, and it's not difficult. It doesn't have to be something so extravagant. It can just be something so small. A smile at a stranger, you know? holding open the door for someone.
Ripple effect.
Exactly. So it's just about changing that attitude from can't to can. That's all you have to do. It's not rocket science. It's the simplest, easiest thing like ever, honestly. So
you're a fashion icon, obviously.
Oh God, I don't know about that.
And but you're loved by the paparazzi. So what is, you know, what is your wardrobe made up of? What is it that you love?
My wardrobe is actually very simple. I'm a strong advocate in that you should wear what you feel comfortable in. Don't follow trends, because not every trend will, for example, suit your body type. And like, if you want to dress up as Batman, dress up as Batman. You know, style is something that's very personal to you. I like keeping it very simple, but that's the standard model look of skinny jeans and a t-shirt or shorts and a t-shirt. But then I love dressing up. I love when on shoots, whether they're fashion shoots or film shoots, you get to transform into a different character. So I love experimenting, but I think style is a very personal thing. Don't copy someone else's style. Find something that works for you and go with it. And keep experimenting. If other people don't like it, who cares? As long as you like it, that's the important thing.
So, I mean, obviously you're making a name for yourself in Bollywood, and you're internationally, you know, you're a supermodel. So do you ever get used to being a celebrity?
Oh no, for me it's just like, I'm just Elena, like that's it. When people ask for like selfies or people are taking photos, I'm just, I don't know, it feels like an out of body experience, you know, it doesn't feel like me. For me, I'm just Elena, that's it.
Do you get mobbed?
Sometimes, yeah. I don't know, you just go with the flow of it kind of thing. Like, I'm very grateful for where I am today, but it's been a lot of hard work.
It must
yeah, people,
take,
yeah,
yes.
Because people don't see what goes on behind the scenes. They just see the final product, which is the glitz and the glamour. There's so much that goes on behind the scenes.
I know. Yeah. So you have a degree in law. You're pursuing your master's in international law. If you were not an actress and a supermodel, is that something that you would be doing?
Oh yes, no, 100%. I would be in the legal field, whether it would be as a legal advisor in the government or
taking up cases for animals.
Yeah, I mean, Peter do a great job of that. Like, we have the RSPCA in the UK, which have the highest level of like private prosecution cases. Okay. So definitely for the underdog, 100% always. But I've always been a super geek. I've always been very academic. And that's something that I still continue today, you know, juggling both. Because for me, I've always loved studying. I mean, education isn't suited to everyone, and that's absolutely fine. But I think it's important to try and teach yourself new skills, whether it being artwork, craftsmanships, apprenticeships. Keep growing. You know, if you want to write poetry, share it on social media, share it on Pinterest, you know, just do things that are new, so then you can add to your portfolio. You know, so then you learn a lot, and that's the only way that you grow. The only way that you grow is by doing something new. And doing something new is very scary. It's very, very scary, but you'll never learn otherwise. Exactly. Like, for example, people are able to speak today because, you know, you learn things as a baby. You learn how to speak. So I feel that in life, the worst thing that can ever happen is someone says no. You know, like, you can go for a job, they might say no. But then you just keep on trying, you try different avenues, you acquire more skills, and you go and you live your dream, and you live your dream for you. That's it.
Leaving behind a legacy is every person's dream. What would you like your legacy to be like?
For me, I would like to change the animal welfare system that we currently have in India. And if anything, I want to change people's mindset in making a difference, because in terms of the fact that everyone can make a change, you know, everyone can make a situation for someone else or something else better. That, I mean, that's the legacy that I want to leave behind, that you've made the world kind of a little bit of a better place. Yeah.
All right.
It's like a Miss Universe thing, you know? I want to make the world a better place, please.
Peace. World peace.
Peace. Yeah, world peace I think is a stretch, but I don't know, making it, leaving the people who are in your circle a bit better off, a bit happier, you know, giving them a different perspective to life. Just being like a good human being so that people can see it's not all darkness in this world, that there is a little bit of light.
And that is how we make a change.
And that is how you make a change. And it's goddamn hard, but it's worth it, you know?
So coming back to films, you're not willing to reveal
anything?
Oh, it's
not that I'm not willing. I'm very willing. I love talking.
I would love to say which projects are for next year, but no, I'm not allowed to. I've read that contract.
Anything in, say, Hollywood or, you know, the English arena?
Yeah, so I'm looking at more Hollywood and British projects simply because I love growing as an individual and I obviously want to expand my portfolio. So for me, it's about the script of a film and how it helps me grow as an actor and what I can deliver to an audience. So I'm open. When people say, oh, what sort of work are you looking for, blah, blah, I'm always open to trying new things. You can only, you know, try everything once, might as well.
True. I believe you're also worked on a web series. How different has that been from, say, your mainstream Bollywood?
Yeah, so for the web series, that was with Sony. And it was very different because it's on a smaller scale, I would say. And my web series was very enjoyable because I knew the whole team because we'd worked together previously on different campaigns. And you have also, I feel, for web series, a different type of audience. Whereas when it's like a big Bollywood blockbuster film, you have a hell of a lot of money. And it's huge. It's a huge production. Yeah, and because there is that platform that is going to be seen by a huge audience, I feel that there's a lot more pressure. I mean, even though you would give it your all, whether it's for a web series or for a film, knowing that something has got such a legacy to it, like Houseful, yeah, the pressure's on, basically. But I feel that film is moving more into that web series area. But for me, it's when you see yourself on a huge screen, it's just like, whoa. Oh, that's how I look. Okay, I get it, yeah.
Any other big names that you want to work with?
I would love to work with, obviously, Shah Rukh. That's a given. And Amir Khan. Okay. I feel that he's really, really brilliant.
Have you met with any of them?
I've met Shah Rukh at an award ceremony. Okay. Yeah. I've never met Amir Khan. Yeah. But I just think they're such staples of Bollywood. You know, they've created such incredible films that just, I mean, Dangal is what, the highest grossing film ever. You know, and I love that film. I think it's amazing. And I think Shah Rukh, I saw his interview with David Letterman recently. Yes. He's got such a funny wit to him. True. Like, I love, it's very British, his humor. It's very,
very,
like, sarcastic.
Spot on, yes.
Yeah, so I just think he's such a breath of fresh air. And for someone who really is, he's such an Indian institution, worldwide, not even just Indian. I think it would be an absolute honor. Even if I had like a 2-second cameo, I would just love it.
Be happy.
Yeah, because it's Shah Rukh Khan.
But then Shah Rukh and Amir are of a different generation. What about the younger generation?
For the younger generation, I mean, I would say maybe Varun. Because he seems quite lighthearted and, you know, jokey and fun. And let me think, who else is it? Oh, Alia. Okay. I think she's incredibly talented. So I loved Razi. I watched that film. Yeah, I've watched that film. Yeah. I think Ananya Pandey has so much potential. I think she's incredibly talented. So obviously her father was in Houseful, a real gentleman, really lovely. But I think Ananya is going to be a huge power force.
Soon.
Oh, 100% soon. I wouldn't even say the next Alia because I don't like comparing people, but I feel that she's going to be huge.
So you plan to stick on in Bollywood for sure?
Bollywood, Hollywood, all of it, yeah. Might as well. You only have one life, so might as well just go for it, you know?
Here and you're here to make
a
name.
Yeah, I'm here, so might as well.
It's been so nice talking to you,
oh,
Elena.
Oh, you too. Thank you so much.
You know, whether it's been striking a pose for our international magazines, wooing everyone with her stunning looks, her talent, working in Bollywood, or setting the red carpet on fire, Elena Fernandez is definitely the next big thing. Thank you so much for being
Elena. You'll be seeing a lot more of me next year. You can't get rid of me. This face is here to stay.
We don't want to get rid of you. You have a beautiful face. We would definitely love to see more.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you so much for being here with us.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.